Hello students, welcome to MBK study. In this video I am going to explain you about the reaction of acids and bases with metals, the reaction of acids with carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonate. So without delay, let's start the topic. Reaction of acids and bases with metals. In this topic, first of all we'll discuss reaction of acids with the metals, then after we'll go to reaction of acid with the bases, reaction of bases with metals. So let's see reaction of acids with metal. So here we are going to show acid reacts with metal and it liberates hydrogen gas. That is our aim, and to do this activity we require the materials like test tube, delivery tube, glass stuff, candle, soap water, dilute HCl, hydrochloric acid and zinc granules. Arrange the setup as shown in the figure. Take 10 ml of dilute HCl in the test tube and few zinc granules. What do you observe on the surface of the zinc granules? We'll observe gas bubbles on the surface of zinc granules. Pass the gas being evolved through soap water with the help of a delivery tube. So this is soap water. So why are bubbles formed in the soap water? Because evolved gas is released in air through soap water. Gas filled bubbles rise into air through soap water. Now bring the burning candle near the gas filled bubbles. What do you observe? You will observe that the gas evolved burns with pop sound indicating hydrogen. The chemical reaction of above activity is acid plus metal gives rise to salt plus hydrogen. So acid we are taking hydrochloric acid and metal is zinc. When they react, then it forms a gas, it evolved a gas, the gas is hydrogen gas. And a salt is remains in the test tube. What is that salt? Is zinc chloride. Repeat the above activity with some other acids like hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, H2SO4, HNO3, nitric acid. So if you react that acid with metals, you can see zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gas is formed. In the same way, when nitric acid is react with metal zinc, then you'll observe that zinc nitrate plus hydrogen gas is released. So what do you observe in all these cases? So from the above activities, you can conclude that hydrogen gas is evolved. Which gas? Hydrogen gas is evolved when acid reacts with metal. The reaction of base with metals. Here, to show bases react with metal and liberate hydrogen gas. To do this activity, we require materials. Test tube, delivery tube, glass stuff, candle, soap water, dilute sodium hydroxide and zinc granules. Arrange the apparatus as shown in the figure. Take 10 ml of sodium hydroxide NaOH in the test tube and a few granules of zinc. The gas bubbles form on the surface of the zinc granules. Pass that gas through with the help of a delivery tube. Gas filled bubble rise into air through soap water. Bring the burning candle near the gas filled bubbles. What do we observe? You'll notice that the gas evolved burns with pop sound indicating hydrogen gas. So chemical reaction of above activity is base plus metal gives rise to salt plus hydrogen. So base we have considered sodium hydroxide, metal is zinc. It releases when they react, then you can see a gas is released, the gas is hydrogen gas. Along with that, salt is formed, sodium zinc here. But here to do this experiment, it is possible when you take a concentrated concentrated sodium hydroxide. Such reaction are not possible for all metals. So it is better to use concentrated sodium hydroxide for this reaction. So precautions to be taken. Hydrogen gas is combustible, so care should be taken while testing the evolved gas with burning candle. Reaction of acids with carbonates. and metal hydrogen carbonates. Take two test tubes, label them as A and B. Take about 0.5 gram of sodium carbonate Na2CO3 in test tube A and about 0.5 gram of sodium hydrogen carbonate NaHCO3 in test tube B. Add about 2 milliliter of dilute HCl to both the test tubes. What do you observe? You observe some gas is evolved. Pass the gas produced in each case through lime water, calcium hydroxide, as shown, and record your observation. The reaction occurring in the above activities are as follows. Na2CO3 sodium carbonate plus HCl hydrochloric acid gives rise to sodium chloride NaCl plus water H2O and carbon dioxide gas. In the same way, sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate NaHCO3 reacts with hydrochloric acid. It gives sodium chloride, water and carbon dioxide gas. So the gas which is formed, that is carbon dioxide gas, if you pass that carbon dioxide gas to calcium hydroxide, that is CaOH, taken twice, then you'll observe a white precipitate is formed, calcium carbonate plus a water, it will be, water is present in that one. On excess carbon dioxide, on passing excess carbon dioxide, the following reaction you can see: CaCO3 plus H2O. In the above reaction, CaCO3 plus H2O, CaCO3 plus H2O, in that one again we are passing carbon dioxide gas, so that's why we are calling it as excess carbon dioxide. So in the following reaction, excess of carbon dioxide if you pass, then it forms CaHCO3, taken twice, that is soluble in water. Thus, from above activities we can conclude that the reaction of metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates with acids gives a corresponding salt, carbon dioxide and water. We can write generalized form of this chemical reaction as shown below. Metal carbonate reacts with acid to give salt, carbon dioxide and water. The same result you will get for the metal hydrogen carbonate or metal bicarbonate. So metal hydrogen carbonate reacts with acid to give salt, carbon dioxide and water. I hope, student, you must have liked this video. If so, please like this video and share it with all your friends. Tell us how you like this video by writing it in the comment box. And if you are not subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe to it and press the bell icon so that you do not miss any of the video that follows. Thank you.